There's a ship. What are you up to up there? Probably nothing we need to worry about right now. Do you need to worry about marauders out here? Sounds like we do. Oh, there's one. Let's see. Okay, that failed miserably. Didn't see him coming, and then I was trying to use a shotgun. Okay, we've loaded him back over here. That's good. So yeah, shotguns, it seems, are close range. We will switch to our assault rifle, even though we haven't got a lot of ammo for it. I suppose we should remember that quick save is a thing as well. Now, there's an enemy. Right, you guys gonna come over? Didn't see what that... Lovely. Yeah, didn't see what that tooltip was saying on the right hand side, because I was too busy engaged in a violent gunfight for my life. But that's fine, we've leveled up again. Now, skills. Skills are all we've got at this level. So we could take that. That would get us up to 30. Engineering. And then we could take a bit of dialogue as well. That sounds good. Unlocks a dialogue combat skill. When attacking the correct type of target, they are automatically debilitated. Okay, so what does that mean exactly? I guess it's because we've reached 20 in Intimidate. Creatures can now become terrified and flee. Cool. So we've got a few different abilities on most types of enemy. But because we've now got 30 in our engineering, I think we are going to just go back and knock off that other quest. Die, robot. Hail, robo friend.
Searching for repair bay. Error. Navigation systems.
Yes, yes. I'm here to fix you.
Navigation systems operational. Optimal path toward repair bay detected. Initiating self-diagnostics.
And yeah, can you give me something for these repairs?
Spacer's Choice reminds all colonists that serving the Spacer's Choice family is the highest possible reward. I have been programmed to deliver this pre-approved message.
Very well. It was worth a try. And yeah, short hop back to Ludwig. Can we just teleport to him? Yeah, we can. Sup, Ludwig?
Bring us honor, soldier.
I have repaired the robot. You won't have to worry about it anymore.
You beat that scout to scrap with its own legs? Pulled its optic cables out its headcase? Actually, don't tell me. Rather use my imagination. You're a passing
I'm happy
fair
to not
soldier,
tell you.
I will confess. But you are one, and the enemy is legion. What you need is an equalizer, a weapon to strike fear in their cold, mechanical hearts. Cantina, lavatory, behind one of the toilets.
Interesting.
That's where I've kept it hidden all these years.
You hid your secret weapon in a toilet.
Sharp, ain't it? The lavatory is the very last place a mechanical has need to enter.
There's actually logic there.
On the double, soldier. Don't want the bartender poking around in there with a mop.
Very well. So I guess we're popping back into town then. We'll find ourselves that secret weapon. I guess it's some sort of energy weapon. And as an energy weapon, it will be good against mechanicals. Now, cantina, toilet. Is it in the canteen? We haven't actually been inside yet. Hello, everyone.
You read the latest report?
We're just here to use the bathroom.
Heavens, folk, hadn't abandoned us.
Kinda.
Yeah, we could use those extra hands.
Nothing we can do about that.
It's a sealed bundle.
We can have another zero G.
So I guess we've got to take this bundle back to Ludwig so it can be unsealed. What's up, boss?
Bring us honor, soldier.
Here's your package.
Feast your eyes, soldier. This here is a genuine Spacer's Choice injury customizing unit, designed to deliver a lethal blast of electrical discharge.
Ooh.
I call it the Hand of the Law. You ever want to see a mechanical flailing around like a grounded fish? You stick a couple thousand volts in its guts. With compliments from old Ludwig.
I mean, that does sound fun.
Fun? This ain't some quarterly performance review, soldier. Ours is a grave and sacred duty. Time's come for you to journey down into the black heart of the enemy's camp. I'm talking about the old geothermal plant.
Hmm.
Unfortunately, the old plant lies outside my board-given jurisdiction. You'll need to get a passcode from the boss, Reed Thompson.
What exactly are you expecting me to find down there, Ludwig?
I need you to get us the brain of a mechanical. Well, not exactly a brain. Anatomically speaking, what we're looking for is a logic module.
Okay. Seems simple enough.
If you die horribly, I will pour out a can of zero-G to your memory.
Good lad. Okay, so we've got a weapon mod. We can install it at a workbench, and that can affect how our weapons work. So, let's see. Mag to zap. Changes the weapon's damage type to shock. Okay, so it will just make any one of our weapons better against mechanicals. That's good, but it's not what we need right now, because now we are going to change back to the medicine quest. And we are going to go back and deal with some marauders. But yeah, this world does look gorgeous. Look at those colours. Look at that volcano. That is a beautiful tree. This is a really pretty game, all told. Now let's go find those bodies that we made earlier and see what's on them. Another assault rifle. Cool. Now there are only two there though. We got killed by a trio earlier. So were they unrelated enemies? Are there three more roaming about looking to murk us? I mean, there's a guy. Oh, there's a whole bunch of them. So if we wait here, they're going to come around the corner, right? And then they're going to get shotgun. Cool, that works out. Now they're not sure where we are. They know we're around, but they don't know where. You gonna keep coming, friend? Yeah, they're right there. Very well. Use your quick melee button to knock back enemies with your ranged weapon. So we can bop people to move them back. And then we can kill them. Very well. Now, is there anyone in this room? It did look as though there were some people upstairs, so they might be in this building. Oh, we got a flywheel. That's possibly just junk, actually. I don't know why I got excited about that. It looked like a quest item, because valves like that are often quest items in games. But yeah, it's probably just junk. Now, if there is anyone around, they're in that room that's currently closed. So let's see. Aha! No, it's not around. But there's a door. It's quite locked. We still haven't found any more lockpicks. Maybe we should at some point. But for now, I guess we continue to sneak about the gaff. Right, a couple of bods over there. Aren't particularly aware of us right now. If we can lure them round a corner again, then that would be beneficial, I think. So we could lure them around this way. Let's see, or are they further up still? Okay. There they are. We've discovered the community centre. Good. Top stealth. Right, so yeah, they know we're here. Well, the one that's still alive knows we're here. Oh no, there's some more. Very well. Yeah, they're kind of onto us. Are they going to come around? Say hello? Yep. We'll just grab your loot while we got a second. The others might be too far away, or they're just more cautious. Yeah, they're more cautious, perhaps. Down they go. A bit more ammo for our stuffs. We're about to go indoors, so we probably want the shotgun back. Where did that second body go? There it is. So yeah, shotgun at the ready. And we're in. And they're sneaking about the gaff. Looking for loot. Hmm? Our stealth isn't the highest in the world. Well, that guy heard that. Didn't really help him. So they're all going to settle down in a moment. Except for this lad, who's desperate to find us. Rawr. Did he literally just say rawr? Oops. Something there. Did you just run around me, knobhead? Cool, that's most of the dudes down. There's one more about, I think. Here they come. Yeah, the ability to make them cower is pretty handy. Soul tuna. Let's see, the fish live in the ocean and perish after a single reproductive episode. And then we scoop up their corpses, clean them, process them, can them, and deliver them straight to your dinner table. Very well. What is that? Primals. Oh yeah, we saw a few of those at one point earlier. And then we've got these little war dog things that the marauders sometimes have about them. Canid. Okay. What was over here? Coming soon. The Manta Queen. I don't know if we want to know what a Manta Queen is, to be honest. First aid room key. We need that. There's a compute we can't hack very well. There's noises in here, but I don't think it's hostile noises, but I could be wrong. Let's just keep hoovering up all the loot without worrying too much about it. No, it could be a canid, I guess. No, it's those little guys. They seem pretty chill, all told. We can use this terminal of direct picket. And we've got messages and whatnot. So, the keycard encoder in the lobby is up and running. Now, let's see. If it breaks down again, you can borrow a keycard from the director or a worker in the second floor. Manta Queen is using up all the budget. Right. Okay, so they sent out... They paid for a bunch of highly skilled hunters to go out and get a Manta Queen to bring it back for the exhibit. They're all dead. Okay, so the whole place probably went out of business because of that mission that they had to find the Manta Queen. More Corporation Service Awards. That's a couple of them we've picked up now. Are they junk? Or are they quest? Yeah, they're junk. Sounds about right for the type of awards that you get given by corporations. Reward and recognition programs. Little cost-effective attaboys to keep your staff working, rather than paying them an increased wage. Got to motivate them in the most cost-efficient ways possible. Now, oh, hello. Deary me. I wasn't expecting there to be any more guys in here. Oh, right, control armor. Did I miss that last time I came through? Maybe. Is it worth grabbing and putting on? I mean, given as we just died, it might be worth putting on some armor. Ah, town and country was the armor. That solves that mystery. Stealth skills, tech skills. Tech skills and 9 armor. Whereas the one we've got now is 3 armor. So yeah, let's equip that one. That one is basically the same, except it's light armor. And what's the difference between light and heavy armor? Is it making us move slower or making us less stealthy? It's probably just making us less stealthy. But we're not too worried about stealth, so let's break that one down. Right, and this time we'll be ready, because we'll be sneaky stealthy. He doesn't even know we're here. Okay, now he knows we're here, and most of those shots were ineffective, to say the least. Okay. Yeah, different gun. Oh, piss. We're dead again. I wasn't expecting them to kill me that time. But they did. So maybe we should be using a bit of this. That went much better. Note to self, use time dilation more. Maybe we should probably stay crouched in case there's more dudes sneaking up on us at some point. Well, hey, it's easier to look out for loot if you stood up. Alright, now where are we? Some sort of pedestal. With some notes on it. Maybe. We can't read them. Very well. And then that's back to where we came in, perhaps. That's bad. So yeah, we could now hack that. But is it worth it? We've already got a keycard. So maybe not. I feel like everyone around here is dead. But then I've thought that before, and I was wrong. Alright, doesn't seem to be much going on up here. Maybe I am going to have to hack that computer down in the lobby. I'm not seeing any keycards lying around that could help me get in there without it. Mechanical Guides to Mechanical Engineering Volume 1. Is that good? Seems to be a quest item. As does an antique saber. And then we've got our punch card for the first aid room in the community centre. So is there a door somewhere that I've missed that will let us into it? Because we've got this door, but it's barred. So that makes me think I've got to get in from another way. And then open that door from the inside. But I don't recall there being any doors. That would let me into it. Unless it's this door. That'll do it. So yeah, that leads back out there. Good. So we haven't had to hack that computer out front. Because we are fairly low on hacking consumables at this point. Now, is anyone in here? Doesn't look like it. Aha! Yep. Good. Got another mod, but it was called Shore Grip, so it's probably for melee weapons. Aha, I'm encumbered. Spacer's Choice commends you for putting company profits ahead of your spinal health. Very well. I mean, we can deal with that easily enough. We can dismantle things, right? Trip blades aren't worth a lot of cash, I don't think. Although, sentry sabers are worth less. Impact hammers are worth good money. We've already got a sword off shotgun, so we could melt down the second one. We could melt these pistols, get some parts and everything. That doesn't sell very much. Do we need a light assault rifle? I think the answer's just no. Stun baton does shock damage. That's cool. Right, now we're back down to 47 out of 60 for our equipment. So, yeah, breaking stuff down into parts is definitely saving us a lot of inventory space. Now, there's the meds I came for. Good. That will give us a ton of XP. Can we fast travel from within this building to where we need to go? Regional map. Cannot fast travel from this location. Very well. I shall go outside then. And then we shall fast travel. Now, there's our friend Esther. I'm going to assume that he doesn't have the plague. And I'm going to give the medicines to Esther.
I've got some time.
You got some time? I got some medicine.
Thanks. I'll see to it that this medicine gets to the people who need it. Here, something for your trouble. Nothing personal, but I hope we never do business together again.
Fair.
Don't want to make a habit of consorting with smuggler types.
Now, let's see. We could charm her at this point. Yeah, why not?
You do have some cheek on you. Lucky for you, I kept a little contingency fee in case you tried to negotiate with me.
Nice. And now, what exactly are you doing with that medicine?
Somebody deserving. Silas, on account of him being out in the cold. Amelia, seeing how she's around people all the time. Anybody in the sick room?
Cool, so it's going to go to people that actually need it. And what is it you actually do here?
Oh, I'm an actuary. That means I keep tabs on a worker's living expenses. How much it costs to feed, clothe, shelter, bury, and replace your average human worker. Technically, I'm employed by the Spacer's Choice Department of Human Resources.
Lovely. Well, see you later, Esther. And it's another level up. That's just spiffing. Now, this one gives us a perk point as well as skills. So, do we push... Let's see. Do we push long guns up higher at this point? Or do we keep working on tech and dialogue. Ah, hack and lockpick are both in stealth. So we'd want some of that as well, generally. Leadership we don't care about. It doesn't really matter if our companions are doing much damage or not, I don't think. Defense, I'm not that bothered about, really. I don't think. Melee, we don't care about. Let's put 5 more into dialogue to get persuade up to 40. That'll increase the duration of Carol when they're fighting humans. And then maybe we'll put 5 more into tech. And that will give us science 30, but it doesn't boost anything up to the next level, but that's fine. That will do nicely. And then perks. Where was the sprint speed? There it is. Cheetah. Let's grab that. Whole lot of perks to look at down the line. Should be fun. But for now, it'll take that. It can be increased again, possibly, because it looked as though it was only taking 1 mark in it, but maybe not. Yeah, actually, based on the icons, they all just look like that, where you've got one little bit at the bottom. So what might we want to take next before we go up to tier 3? Base health? It might be useful. We'll worry about that down the line, though. Next thing we need to worry about, based on the fact that we've only really got 1 quest left. Well, we've got 2 quests left, but they both involve talking to Reed, I think. So that will be our next goal.
You think corporate's ever gonna visit?